Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Somerset College Preparatory Academy Charter High School, the faculty, its staff, and student body, it is an honor to welcome each and every one of you to our 8th annual commencement ceremony. My name is Erica Rains, and I'm the principal of Somerset College Prep, and I am thrilled you guys are able to be here with us today. I do want to give you all a moment to check and silence your cell phones, please. Your students have worked very hard for today's recognition, and I want your attention on them and not your phones. So please take a moment to silence your cell phones. Before we begin with the Pledge of Allegiance, I would like to ask all of our active duty service members and veterans and law enforcement officers to stand and be recognized. We thank you for your service. I'd like to invite Gianni Joseph Gauthier up to the podium to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the national anthem performed by Class of 2023 member Isabel Crystal Stevens.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
You may be seated.
Thank you, Gianni and Isabel. Great job, Isabel. Can we hear it again for them? As the principal of Somerset College Preparatory Academy Charter High School, I now declare the 2023 commencement ceremony officially open. The class of 2023 is our 8th graduating class. 117 seniors are sitting on this stage with us today. Of the 117 sitting here today, 2 are actually graduating a year ahead of schedule, and 1 is graduating 2 years ahead of schedule. You may have noticed the cords weighing down their necks of many of these as they came in during the processional. The cords that you saw indicate a GPA of 4.0. 117 graduates sitting here, 29 of them are wearing this gold cord. And again, that is high honors. Honors is a GPA of 3.5 up to a 4.0. There are 31 of these students wearing the silver cord, indicating honors. That means that 51%, more than half, of our graduating class is graduating with honors. Two of them are graduating with the Florida Seal of Biliteracy, and what that means is that they took 4 years, not the required 2 years, but 4 years of the same foreign language. Of the 117 of them up here, 53 of them are sporting white cords, indicating their civic mindedness. These 53 students have 250 or more hours of community service that they have dedicated to our community over the last 4 years. This class has a collective over 36,817 volunteer hours between them. With the most hours at 3,364 hours, Miss Harley Fleschner. So in addition to being awesome with their volunteering and getting out in the community, this class has another thing to boast. It is the first graduating class with the collective number of scholarship dollars that they have. It's the highest one we've had so far in 8 years, over 6.2 million scholarship dollars. As impressive as those statistics are, even more impressive might be the 13 students who worked to complete not only their high school diploma, but concurrently took college classes and have already graduated from IRSC with their associate's degree. Please stand and be recognized. About our school, you know that the level of at which our instructors teach, it's not easy. Often the students who participate in dual enrollment classes at IRSC say that the college classes are easy compared to some of their high school classes. I think that sentence usually has the name O'Connor in there somewhere. These students deserve another round of applause. The next group of students that I would like to stand and be recognized are the 24 students who are wearing a teal cord. They are in the top 20% of their graduating class. They are recognized by the state as the talented 20. These students are guaranteed admission to one of the 12 state universities. Congratulations. Woo! The teal and white cord worn by some of our students is an indication of the scholar diploma designation. It's a state designation and it's one of the most difficult to achieve. These students have earned a credit in Algebra 2 or an equally rigorous course. They've passed the Geometry EOC. They've earned a credit in Statistics or an equally rigorous course. They've passed the Biology EOC. They've earned a credit in Chemistry and or Physics and an equally rigorous course. They've passed the U.S. History EOC, and they've earned 2 credits in the same consecutive foreign language course and at least 1, if not more, AP or dual enrollment courses. 17 of our students are wearing the teal and white cord and have graduated with this distinction. This graduating class has a 95% acceptance rate, with students being accepted to universities such as University of Miami, Polytech, Penn State, Howard University, FAMU, NYU, Columbia, Rollins, UConn, George Mason University, FSU, USFU, CF, Colorado State, FGCU, Embry-Riddle, Savannah College of Art and Design, Spelman University, FAU, and FIT, just to name a few. Today, we join you, the class of 2023, in marking the successful completion of your formal learning experience at Somerset, as well as the beginning of a new and exciting part of your lives. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce and recognize some of our special guests that we'll be hearing from later. I'd like to recognize Dr. Ruth Jacoby. She is the Somerset Academy Executive Director of Education and founding Somerset Academy Principal. Thank you for being with us here today. And our keynote speaker today's name is Frank Coppola III, and I will be telling you quite a bit about him shortly, but I do want to say thank you for joining us today. Now, as has become tradition, we will hear from the president of the Student Government Association for the class of 2023, Brianna Ariel Tucker, with a speech, the senior speech of gratitude. She is known as both a mini Butler and a mini Sinsky. Brianna is 20th in her class with a 4.2 GPA and scholar designation. She has over 300 volunteer hours. She's a member of the National Honor Society, a recipient of the Daughters of the American Revolution Scholarship. She's going to be going to Florida Gulf Coast University to study secondary social studies education, and when she's done with that, hopefully she'll be returning to teach for her alma mater. Brianna?
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. I would like to thank all the families, friends, students, and staff who have come out today to support the class of 2023. I would also like to say a special thank you to the juniors who are helping working today's event. I think I speak for many of the seniors when I say that I am proud of you, and I cannot wait to see all that you will accomplish. I would also like to extend my gratitude to a few groups of people who have gotten me to this point. First, I'd like to say thank you to my family, to my mom. You have been there for me every step of the way, and you have put in countless hours to get me to this point. And to my dad, my uncle, and my grandparents, you may have been miles away, but without a second thought, you have listened to me, and you have always been there to remind me that it's okay to take breaks and relax. To my brother, I think I'm going to miss you. However, I'm not going to miss when you randomly decide to cut in front of me on the sidewalk, take over my bedroom like it's yours, or punch me whenever you see a yellow car. Daniel, I have spent 4 years building up the reputation of Tucker. Make sure you live up to the hype, and please don't screw it up. And to my stepdad, Darren, who couldn't be here today, thank you for telling me over the past few years that I would become a history teacher. Tosinski, where do I even begin? It seems like ever since I set foot on the Somerset campus, I have known you. And it's crazy to think that it's been 4 years since I've been sitting in your class by the door of room 230, taking your US history class, and in the next semester, taking your ethics and law class. I guess that's one thing I can thank guidance for, because since then, I've been tasked, designated, or drafted to be one of your student aides. You did your job as a teacher by making sure I knew good history. But I think I have learned so much more by being your student aide than from your actual classes. That being said, here are a few of the things that I have learned. My tech skills are really bad. Really, really bad. I know how to make fancy booklets using the copy machine. And no matter how many times I organize your desk, it will always revert to the dumpster fire that it was a few class periods ago. And I think I might have a minor in sarcasm, all thanks to you. For all that you have taught me, you have also been there to support me and push me to take on new challenges. Like that one time you volunteered me to do SGA. I have now been in SGA for 3 years, and it has been quite a journey from being a grade representative to the first Poseidon prefect, and now standing here as the SGA president. I know that you know how much it has become a part of who I am, and I could not have made it here without you encouraging me along the way. Thank you, Mr. Sinsky. Keep it real. A lot of the time, people consider the things that teachers do for their classes and their school as part of their job. However, Ms. Butler, you are a teacher and somehow you even make English entertaining. But on top of that, for the past 6 years, you have been in charge of the club that organizes homecoming, fundraisers, food and blood drives, house games, teacher appreciation week, or to summarize, most of the school events. Most people get overwhelmed by their jobs, daily life, and other responsibilities, but because you are the person you are, you decided to adopt another 30-something kids and guide them to become leaders and role models themselves. I have grown up so much in the past 4 years, and I have to say that a huge part of that has been because of you. You have never failed to remind me to walk instead of run everywhere, or that I needed a step stool to reach your board. And I know that it isn't a high bar to clear, but your organization skills are way, way better than Sinsky's, and they were greatly appreciated. I could probably stand up here for hours crying, or trying not to cry, telling everyone here how much of an impact you have made on my life. But I know that eventually we all want to go home. I will end by saying how lucky I am to have had you as a teacher, advisor, and role model. And while I may have been one of Sinsky's kids first, I am forever grateful that I got to be one of your kids too. I have learned so much from you, and I think it speaks for itself that the SGA kids have called me the SGA mom, and the other staff had called me the mini you. To Rains, thank you for supporting SGA, because without you, us competing and winning at district and state competitions would not have been feasible. Thank you to Ms. Silva for tolerating the number of times I have asked for change in quarters. Thank you to Mr. Marsh for the positivity that you bring to every day. I and all of your students appreciate it. And Ms. Brown for allowing me to work on all the SGA things during your class. I want to say thank you to my dearest companion, Ketcher Lingen. I cannot string enough words to tell you how thankful I am for you. It has been one of the most challenging years of my life. Between being a senior and all the other things life has decided to throw my way, I have had my fair share of daunting mornings, unmotivated afternoons, and sleepless nights. And for the past year, you have been there to support me through it all. whether it was through your stupidly bad jokes, your type B personality tendencies, or just being there because I needed you. Thank you for believing in me and reminding me of how amazing I am. Next, I would like to thank the people I am happy to call my friends. Shore, Dr. Patel, Brianna, Lee Parker Williams, and Ozzy, my blubber butts. Even though I have complained about all the times you have had to drag me out and hang out, I really do appreciate you guys for getting me out there. You are some of the best people I know, and I know that you guys will do great things. And even if we go our separate ways, I know that we will be supporting each other from afar. I cannot wait to see who each of you become, and thank you for the lasting impact you have had on my life. I want to say thank you to those who I've shared classes with, because I will always remember Miss Devereaux's English class and the chaos that ensued because of the oats that were passed around and eaten. To Miss Brown's anatomy and physiology class, thank you for the eclectic group of boys, Emiliano, Dylan, Austin, Blaze, Caden, Jason, and the rest of you who sat back there. Thank you for being a good distraction with your interesting conversations. And to the front table, Nick, Mia, and Adriana, for always wanting my opinion on the strangest topics. To Miss Butler's English 4 class, thank you for always turning in your work late and making me go back and regrade it. You have really prepared me for my future of teaching. And finally, thank you to my SGA seniors, and I'm sure the amount of tears cried today does not add up to the amount of tears cried on the bus back to the hotel after our first state competition. And to the entirety of the graduating class of 2023, I know that most graduation speeches have some amazing life lesson, theme, or something to them. However, as much as I've tried, I just really couldn't find a piece of advice or motto that would drive things home the way I'm feeling. So to provide that extra inspirational sentiment, I look to add a quote from a historical famous person like George Washington, Susan B. Anthony, or Aristotle. And while all those people have said great things, they just didn't say what I was hoping to say. Ultimately, I think there's one quote that sums up my high school experience and motivates me as I move on into my new phase of life. And I want to leave you with the words of comedian Jon Stewart in hopes that it does the same for you. Love what you do. Get good at it. Competence is a rare commodity in this day and age, and let the chips fall where they may. And as we leave here today, my life without each of you would be just a little different. Thank you to the class of 2023 for the laughs, the tears, and the memories. And I wish you the best of luck in your future endeavors. Congratulations, we did it!
Thank you, Brianna. Seniors, take a moment to look that direction. Find your families out in the audience. Seniors, do you see all those smiles? Do you see the smiles in the audience? Do you know why they're smiling? They're smiling because their 13 long years of waking you up, fixing you breakfast, driving you around, fighting with you to get your homework done is finally over. Those faces that you're looking at right now, seniors, those faces that you're looking at right now as you sit here on this stage today, I think that you guys owe them a round of applause. And now, with the senior farewell, a junior class rep who has been in SGA for the past 2 years. She's recently been elected to serve as her class's senior secretary for the 23-24 school year with a GPA of 3.63, attending Nova Southeastern University to study psychology when it's her time to walk across the stage. Please welcome to the stage, Kaylani Arnold. Woo!
Thank you, everyone. Let me see if I can try to do this without crying. There's definitely going to be maybe a few tears because... Okay. To my dear class of 2023, as I stand before you today, I am filled with mixed emotions. On one hand, I am proud of all that you have accomplished, and I am excited for what the future holds for every single one of you. On the other hand, I am sad to say goodbye and see you leave this chapter of your lives behind. Over the past 4 years, we have seen you grow and mature into the incredible individuals that you are today. You have worked hard to achieve your goals, overcome obstacles, and create lasting memories with your friends and classmates. And now, as you prepare to move on to the next phase of your lives, I want to remind you of a few things. First and foremost, never forget the importance of perseverance. Life is not always easy, and there will be times when you face challenges and setbacks. But in these moments, your strength and character will shine through. Believe in yourself, stay focused on your goals, and keep pushing forward no matter what. Secondly, always remember the power of relationships. The bond you have formed with your peers, teachers, and family members will stay with you for the rest of your life. Stay in touch with those who have made a positive impact on you and seek out new relationships that will help you grow and succeed in the future. My last reminder for you is that you are capable of achieving great things. Whether you go on to college, enter the workforce, or pursue other endeavors, you have the potential to make a significant impact in the world. So dream big, work hard, and never give up on your goals. As I stare onto the stage and see so many familiar faces, I can't help but be filled with pride, staring back at the best senior class that there possibly is. Well, I mean, of course that is until the class of 24. So many of you guys have not only treated me as family, but helped me become a better person and showed me how to live life to the fullest. And I'll miss you all dearly. I'll always remember you guys, since this is the class I've always looked up to. At this time, I'd like to start making some direct addresses to some of you guys. Starting with you, Mr. Spratley. To my dear brother, words cannot explain how proud I am of you right now. Usually, you have quite the reputation as a troublemaker, and I refuse to claim you as my family since it always confuses and shocks all of the staff members. But at this moment, while I look at you, I can't believe all the joy and happiness that's running through my veins knowing that you finally made it. I love you, Makai, and I know that's weird for me to say, but I really do. And I'm so incredibly grateful to be here on this stage to not only tell you that you did exactly what nobody thought you could do, but you also made everybody in this room proud by proving us wrong in these moments. Just please, 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 please promise not to go Hollywood on us. We're still your family. Don't disappear. And don't forget about me. Love your sister. To Mr. Evan Fuentes, you're another one that I'm gonna miss dearly. Although all of our group hangouts will come to an end and I won't get to see you running around campus with your ukulele anymore, I'm excited to see what's in store for you next. Keep your head up and stay reaching for the stars. Just don't go too far though, because you still owe me that crumble cookie. To Miss Crystal Gutier, I'm sorry, I just pronounced your name wrong. I can sit here all day and ramble about how much we've grown since our days in Southport together, but I'm gonna keep it short by saying you were like a sister to me, and I can't wait to see how far you go. From painting the gym walls together to you remembering me as that one chick with red hair in middle school, I'll cherish all the laughs that we shared. To our dear valedictorian, Miss Juliet Puig, I wish we had the chance to be friends way sooner. Within the short time frame I've gotten to know you, I've enjoyed your friendship and all the time we spent together. You're ever so sweet and caring, and I'll miss seeing that smile all around campus. Just promise to bring me some Chick-fil-A before you go. And of course, to Mr. Darion Freeman. I hope throughout all this time, you finally learned not to park on my side of the driveway when you're stopping by the house for visits. You may have thought that I've never acknowledged you, but boy, would you be wrong. I know how hard you worked for this and what you've been through, and I want you to know that I'm especially proud of you. You really need to stop parking on my side of the driveway, though. It's not cool. And just to list a few more people who've impacted my life for the better, to Miss Isabella Padilla, Miss Isabel Stevens, Miss Olivia Ivarone, Miss Amaya Joseph, Mr. Dante Jenkins, Mr. Maximino Whitehead, Mr. Seth Paley, and Mr. Colin Cash. Thank you. Thank you guys for all of the kindness and care you have shown me during our time here together. Each and every one of you not only hold a special place here at Somerset, but you also hold a special place in my heart. To my Student Government Executive Board, I want you to know that it was an honor to be a part of student government under your term. I would like to thank each and every one of you for being great leaders and setting the place for those who are taking your spots. To my President, Brianna Tucker, for as long as I've known you, you were always aiming for the stars while caring for us like we were family. Words can't express how happy I am to see you finally get what you deserve. To my Vice President, Ozzie Sternberg, I thank you every day for bringing me more and more out of my shell. I find this really funny because last year at graduation, I sat in the crowd watching you give this speech to our outgoing seniors, and this year I get to repay that to you. I am so glad that in your final year here at Somerset, we were able to get close. From crying at districts because our booked place, to counting down and crying every day we realized that your senior year was ending, I can't wait to see all the great things that you'll start to do when you're a freshman at Wrangling. And yes, don't worry, I'll bring you back for prom, graduation, and every other event I'm gonna sneak you back into. To my treasurer, Milan Patel, although you were ever so cocky all of the time, I think I might just miss you the most. You always lifted the mood with your jokes and threats whenever the money count was off. From running around Walmart looking for squishmallows and throwing insults at each other, playfully of course, I do truly hope you get all the happiness you deserve. To my senior representative, Dylan Harry Passad, I wish I had gotten the opportunity to know you better during your time here at Somerset. Although we weren't too close, I'd be lying if I were to say that I wasn't proud of you. I want you to know that you're gonna do great things in the future, and I'm here rooting for you. Last but not least, to my secretary, Carly Abraham, I thank you with every bone in my body for paving the way for me. For years, I've always looked up to you, and for the last couple months where we did get closer and you taught me your ways of being secretary, I've always been thankful. I promise that as your successor, I'll make you proud, and I'll get that medallion book for FASC 24 done. As you all prepare to leave high school and embark on the next chapter of your lives, I want to leave you with one final thought. Remember that you are not alone. You have the support and encouragement from everyone here today, and we will always be cheering you on as you chase your dreams and pursue your passions. Congratulations, class of 2023. I am honored to have been a part of your journey and can't wait to see all that you will accomplish in the years ahead.
Thank you, Miss Arnold. Okay, most of the students who have earned scholarships or recognition have done so before today. We usually do those at the senior banquet. However, there are two scholarships that we typically reserve for presentation at graduation. The recipients are unaware that they're going to receive it until their name is called. I would like to introduce the outgoing president of the National Honor Society, Milan Patel. He will share more about the organization and present these scholarships. These scholarships are entitled If Not Me Then Who and the NHS Academic Achievement Award. The If Not Me Then Who scholarship is a tribute to the students from Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School who went back into the building to assist their classmates. When asked why they went back in, they responded with If Not Me Then Who. The NHS Academic Achievement Award is for the student with the highest weighted GPA and their associate's degree. Milan will share a little bit more about the type of Spartans who qualify for scholarships like these. Milan.
It's a little short. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, faculty members, parents, and most importantly, my fellow graduates.
Today, as we gather here to commemorate our achievements and bid farewell to this remarkable year, I stand before you in awe of the incredible accomplishments we have made as a collective force. This year has been one heck of a journey, and together we have proven that passionate individuals can come together and there is no limit on what we can achieve. Throughout the year, we have undertaken numerous initiatives that have left a lasting impact not only on our community, but our school as well. One such endeavor was our partnership with Toys for Tots, where we came together as a class and as a school and donated toys to children in need. We didn't stop there. Our school-wide food drive exemplified the spirit of service as we rallied together to support our local veterans in need. Through our collective efforts, we were able to help feed those who have selflessly served our nation. In this moment, like these, it is moments like these that remind us the power we possess to affect positive change in our society. During the holiday season, we were able to help less fortunate families by donating gift cards as small gestures to help bring warmth and hope to those facing challenging circumstances. But today, I'm not here to talk about all about our society and our school and what we did throughout the year. But I'm here to bestow two awards to two hardworking and compassionate seniors. The first award is the NHS Academic Award. This prestigious award acknowledges one senior's exceptional academic achievements. A senior who is set to receive their high school diploma alongside their Associate of Arts degree from Indian River State College, as well as having the highest weighted GPA within the graduating class. This reward represents scholarship, one of the four National Honor Society pillars. I am proud to award the certificate and $750 scholarship to Patricia Orlean. The second award is the If Not Me and Then Who Award, a testament to the importance of NHS place, the importance in the NHS pillar service. This award acknowledges a senior who has selflessly served their school, fellow students, or the community without any expectation or recognition or reward. This person was nominated by our faculty and had to write written testimonials proving that this person deserved the award. The senior will be receiving a plaque and a $1,000 scholarship. I am thrilled to know and award this award to Brianna Tucker. Congratulations. You love me. Congratulations to all my fellow graduates. The future waits us with boundless possibilities. I have no doubt that we will continue to inspire, serve, and lead with some dedication and passion that we have brought here today. Thank you, and may the rest of your journeys be filled with happiness and success.
Thank you, Milan, and congratulations to Brianna and Patricia. Good job, girls. And now I'm going to introduce you to this year's salutatorian. Please welcome Somerset's very own, with a GPA of 4.8, Milan Patel. Milan has completed... Go ahead. Milan has completed his associate's degree at IRSC. With over 500 volunteer hours, he is a member of every single honor society we have at our school. His neck is weighed down. He serves as the president of the National Honor Society, the treasurer of the Student Government Association, treasurer of the National English Honor Society. He has been offered more than $275,000 worth of scholarships. He has been accepted to Penn State, UCF, USF, Florida Tech, FAU, PBA, Rollins, University of Virginia at Wise, but he plans to continue his Bachelor's of Information Studies at Florida State University. With a medallion Bright Future Scholarship. Salutatorian, Milan Patel.
They made me go sit down for dramatic effect. Higher? Yeah. Nah, that's too much work. Good evening. First, I would like to say, I didn't expect writing a speech to be this hard. I wrote like four drafts of this, and they went from a roast, to a story, to different things. I didn't go with the roast, sadly, because Ms. Butler told me that I had to get it approved by Rains, and I didn't want to do that. So I just thought I'd go with it. There are so many components that led me to where I am, and I just wanted to share some of the things that brought me here. So I'm as Kehlani said, I'm a little cocky. I can say that I'm proud of where I am, but being salutatorian was one of the hardest things for me to ever achieve. Even though our principal thought I was valedictorian since the start of the year, telling people like Brian Mast that I was valedictorian, and then I corrected her. She said salutatorian. I said, she's like top 10. I said nope. She said you're up there though, and I said sorta. It wasn't so simple. For those who don't know, in the last year, I've moved 20 spots. At the start of the year, I was around 24, and I moved up to salutatorian. I ended the year completing 13 courses with straight A's. I worked tirelessly to get where I am, and quite frankly, the only time I felt happy about being salutatorian was when my name was called at the award banquet. As I think back, I did not regret what I did, but I question why I did it. What drove me to do all this work? And why did I put myself in so many pressured situations just for a title? I didn't do it for my family. I didn't do it for my college applications. I did it mainly to rub it in my friends' faces that I'm academically better than them. However, my friends are the only reason I stayed sane. Listening to me complain about all the classes I was taking became a reoccurring thing. A common response of, well, you did it to yourself, became a common phrase in their vocabulary. Many of my friends need no recognition by name, as they know who they are. They know what they did for me and know how they supported me. Whether it was late night study sessions, taking well-deserved breaks to the movie theater, going to the beach, or staying in and just talking for hours. They stood by me and supported me in and out. Without them, I wouldn't have been able to achieve what I have today. I wanted to thank my family and my adoptive families, the Horners, the Sternbergs, the Tuckers, and the Johnsons, for welcoming me into your homes and treating me as your own. I wanted to thank the staff that treated me so well and showed me the ways, especially people like Ms. Silva. Though half of our encounters were you just yelling at me, I have gained a new level of respect for what you do. Ms. Russo, for teaching me that half of your job is just paperwork and half of it gossip. And always... and always making time in your busy schedule for me to come complain about my classes. Ms. Butler, for being a person I could rely on anytime I needed, and having unwavering honesty was always appreciated, especially when it wasn't in my favor. It was rarely not in my favor. Ms. O'Connor, you have shown me that through hard work and dedication, anything is possible. Ever since I met you in the ninth grade, I knew I had to get a recommendation letter from you. If you could write a recommendation like you tell your stories in class, I knew schools would just have to accept me. I wanted to wish my underclassmen the best on their next endeavors. I took some of you under my wing and showed you the ways of our education system. And I hope to receive phone calls that you got into your top choices. To my group within SGA, the SSA, stay strong, States is near, you'll have your fun there. Finally, I wanted to thank the most important person in my life. They stood by me through thick and thin. I have looked up to them for most of my life, and up until recently, they have begun looking up to me. They showed me that hard work meant you had to party harder, and without my brother, I wouldn't be the person I am today. He has been there for me since I can remember, and he's the only reason I work so hard, the only reason I do what I do, and the reason I am so competitive. In the end, class of 23, the future is bright for us. We are bound to make a lasting impact and derive change. I have had the opportunity to work and talk to many of you, and I'm glad to call you my peer and friends. As I wrap up, I wanted to quote one of my biggest inspirations and mentors, Kiran Manjarwala. But for a few moments, I would like for everyone seated here to do the same. Reflect. Think about what has led you here. Graduates, suspend your disbelief and think about the reality of it all. We finally made it. Thank you for your time. Enjoy the ceremony.
Congratulations, Milan. And now for your 2023 Somerset College Prep Academy valedictorian with a 5.06 GPA with over, with over 1,015 community service hours, a talented 20 scholar designation, Florida's Seal of Biliteracy. She's been offered a Medallion Bright Future Scholarship. Juliet Star Puig has already earned her associate's degree from Indian River. She's been accepted to FSU, FAU, UCF, and has committed to the University of Florida to study biomolecular chemistry. Valedictorian Juliet Puig.
All right, so this is not in the speech, but you would think that after Miss Rain said all of that, people would think that I was their valedictorian, and she still thinks it's Milan Patel, okay? I feel very hurt. With that being said, I am incredibly honored to be in front of you today, and I would like to appreciate Brianna Tucker and Milan Patel for having wonderful stories that had to go with their Somerset experiences. And I am also beyond honored to be a part of the first ever Somerset College Preparatory Academy 7th graders to walk through these halls. And I hold these people dear to my heart forever, but the lessons within these halls will carry me into the next chapter of my life, without being too sentimental. Thank you, Mr. Chesare, for dismissing any remark I ever made about being average or normal, and ensuring that I knew that being exceptional was a must and not an option. Ivy, oh my God. I have never met somebody who could fall asleep 8 minutes into an AP test and still be recognized as the top scorer and snorer in the class. You are amazing. I love you. Thank you. Evan, in our group since your first day at Somerset, and I can promise you that I could walk my entire life and never find somebody even as remotely similar to you. I don't even know if I want to, but I still love you. And to my heart, in the form of a human, Leo, thank you for showing me how beautiful this world can be simply because you exist in it. But most importantly, to my mother, oh my God, I'm gonna cry, for raising two exceptional children on her own for many years and therefore yielding me a brother who supports me unconditionally. I owe you the world for sacrificing everything for me when we had nothing, and for marrying someone just as kind. Okay, with that gratitude given, the lessons I have learned at Somerset extend far beyond the classroom. We grew up being told that failure is a sign of being insufficient or incapable of what is required of us, but I did not receive this title because I was the best test taker, or the smartest in every class, or even the most disciplined. I got here because I was the best at failing, but I kept showing up. When I was rejected from the gifted program 3 times, almost failed my college chemistry class, and did in fact fail my AP calculus exam, these rejections became redirections, and now I stand before you as this year's valedictorian, not because I am any smarter than your children, but because I am better at getting up when no one expected me to even try. The only real failure that I learned is that when you stay comfortable in your current situation, success will not grow. And to lose people because they no longer wish that success for you because they are not attached to it means releasing that comfort zone and let them go. The hardest lesson to learn was that no one had to like me, love me, care for me, or even respect me. But when I looked at myself in the mirror, I had to love who was staring back at me. Ooh, forgot the other page. It's embarrassing. All right. That being said, my grandmother would never let me stand up here and speak on the negative. So I want to stand up here and speak about the only thing that I could think about while writing this speech, and that was articulating that I am still grateful for every encounter that I've had with every student in this class. Whether you know me, love me, or wish no association with me, I am grateful for you leveraging your time to make my acquaintance. So as you all take steps forward to who you choose to be, it brings me great pleasure to know that most of you will leave this world a better place than when you entered it. I ask you not to adjust your heart for the sake of being accepted and accessible, but be as much of an inconvenience, but do so with consideration and kindness. I wish you all nothing but the best. Move forward and be exceptional. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Juliet, and congratulations on your distinction as, what is it? Valedictorian? All right. And now I would like to introduce our award-winning choral director, Miss Wallington, our music teacher who will lead the senior class in their alma mater, written by Diamond Rattapannant, graduate of the class of 2017. Miss Wally. Let your school song be an inspiration to you to be brave and bold as you enter this new phase of your life. All right, now it's my honor to present today's keynote speaker. I had the honor of hearing him speak at another event recently, and after hearing his story, I believed with all of my heart that it's a message that each and every one of our seniors sitting up here today need to hear. As you heard with all those statistics, all that data, all those accolades, this is a pretty impressive senior class. You heard about the number of classes they took. Most of you, if you're parents, you know that while the state of Florida requires 24 credits to graduate, we require 27. And just by show of hands, how many of you exceeded the 27? There are students sitting up there who have exceeded 30 hours, 35, 36 hours, because they concurrently take their college classes at the same time as their high school classes. The number of kids up here who have their associate's degrees, the number of kids up here who they feel pressure. You heard Milan talk about the pressure that he chose to put on himself. But a lot of their pressure comes from family members and from wanting to be better, do better, and to succeed. And I think that as a society, a lot of times we have the wrong definition of what success is. And when I heard this keynote speaker today speak at a previous event, I heard him talk about the difference in wealth and success, and I wanted our kids to know that it's not about the almighty A or the almighty dollar. And this keynote speaker, I think he's got a great message. And if you guys will listen, I really want you to hear. He is my gift to you guys today. He is my gift to you guys today. So with that, Frank R. Coppola III has been in the construction industry for almost 20 years. After graduating from Gettysburg College with a business degree, he enjoyed a 10-year career on Wall Street as a commodity trader and an international equity trader. He brings a strong business sense and an array of knowledge of construction to his business. His company is a marquee construction and project management firm specializing in historic residential and complex commercial markets. The Coppola Brothers LLC is licensed in Florida, New Jersey, Texas, and North Carolina. Frank currently serves as the immediate past president of the Metropolitan Builders and Contractors Association of New Jersey, the president of Gold Coast Builders Association of Palm Beach, the Florida Home Builders Association Political Action Committee chairman of the Florida Certified Master Builders Board of Directors, on the Palm Beach County Building Code Advisory Board. He's been the president of the American Taekwondo Academy since 1990, and he's married to his favorite wife, Miranda, for 25 years, and I thank Miranda for getting him here for us today. Please put your hands together for Mr. Frank Coppola.
No pressure after that introduction. I hear those words, I know they're written about me, but in my head, it's not me. Graduates, I graduated high school 37 years ago, and who here has seen or knows Diary of a Wimpy Kid? You know it? Diary of Frank Coppola. You all are so much smarter than me. You're so much brighter than me. You have it all going on. I went to high school every day afraid. Every day. My graduation night, I got jumped by 5 guys. It was not a fun experience. Before I tell that story, I just need to go and talk about your principal for a second. So she heard me speak. And afterwards, she came up to me and she goes, "Mr. Coppola, you're such a motivational speaker. Could I hire you to come speak to our students?" And my wife, who always keeps me in check, laughed. She goes, "Pay him? I listen to him every day." But the words that Principal Rain said, motivational speaker, just hurt me. I have no interest in motivating you. I want to make an impact in you. That is more important to me. And the reason of it comes back to high school. To be a motivational speaker to me in my dumb brain would be the equivalent of somebody going, after I got beat up, someone going to me, "Cheer up, buckaroo." It's empty calories. I have a promise to make. Actually, I can guarantee this is going to be the greatest commencement speech I've ever given, because it's my first. So, when I graduated high school, I wanted 3 things. I wanted to not be afraid, I wanted a girlfriend, and I wanted to be rich. Easy, right? Problem is, I was constantly afraid. I really never had a girlfriend. And I didn't have any money. It was a tall order. Well, graduation night, let's go back to the story. My 5 friends, one guy, Jeff, comes out and goes, "Show me, I want to show you my car." I walk outside, I turn around, there's 5 guys wanting to kick my butt. Now, we all know on TV or on YouTube, there's videos of the rabbit running away from the cheetah. And that was me. I ran for my life. I had never been so scared. Ran, got in the house, and I swore never again. never again. And that begun the first journey of the first reiteration. I needed to shed the skin of my high school self, an abusive father, never, no confidence, had no value for myself. And I decided I needed to reinvent myself. Threw all my clothes out. You know, I was such a nerd. You know, it's no wonder that I got picked on. I never went to school without a collar. Just collar on my shirt. The thought of going to school in my gym clothes was like, who would do that? I threw all my clothes out. I went to college with no collars. I wanted to be in the club. And the first lesson, and one of the speakers said, you didn't have any great quotes. I hope I can leave you with a few. The first thing I want to share is it's really important what room you're in. And I walked into a gymnasium. There was a flyer that said Korean Karate Taekwondo. And I watched this class. And the instructor was a little guy who was chasing a guy my size across the room. And I walked in, and then I walked right back out. I was too scared to go in. I forced myself, you gotta be in the room. This is the room where people know how to defend yourself. Be in that room. And I went into that room, and a woman taught me how to do a block. Taught me how to make a fist, put it over my head, and that was it. Just like that. Value added. She taught me that I knew it was one move at a time that I could learn how to defend myself. I have been teaching martial arts for 37 years. I have, last weekend we had a black belt promotion, and our 387th degree black belt in our school. I have 6 students of mine who have made it to 6th degree black belt. That means they've been in our school for 25 years. I have taught, 25,000 people how to make a fist. Roll your fingers up. This is interactive, by the way. Roll your fingers up, everybody. Don't make me send my wife after you. Roll your fingers up. Come on, everybody. And just bring your hand to your side of the and put it over your head. All right, make that 21,000. The biggest lesson that martial arts taught me was it's not about you. It's about helping somebody else. I get asked all the time, have you ever been in a fight? Yep. I was green belt. I was in college. I'd been doing martial arts for a year and a half. I decided I wanted to see if this stuff worked. I got in a fight. Guy threw a punch at me, blocked the punch, broke his nose, broke his ribs, put him in the hospital. My instructor came to me the next day and he goes, congratulations, you became the thing you despised. Greatest lesson I learned. I have not laid my hands on anybody since 1988, but I use Taekwondo every day. And the key is, it's about empowering and helping others. The organizational chart of anything in business, life, everyone shows the pyramid with the head dude at the top, and that's not how it works. It's at the bottom. That's the first thing I want to share with you, you graduates, you beautiful graduates. Help other people. Put yourself at the bottom and lift other people up. I'm obviously in the construction industry. The greatest buildings have a very strong foundation. If you're going to lead anything, you have to be the foundation. You don't sit at the top of the building. There's no strength in that. That's an ornament. The real strength is in the rock. Is in the rock. And you have a responsibility. Don't become the thing that you despise. You have a responsibility to help others. The reward is amazing. You know, the irony in martial arts is, I went to high school, right? I told you, afraid of every single day. And now, 37 years later, if somebody goes, wow, you're a 7th degree black belt, why do you need 7 degrees of black belt? My joke would be, you don't. But it's really not a joke, you don't. It takes belts 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 to hold back the first one. It takes more control to not hurt somebody than it does to hurt somebody. And the value that you have of helping other people, it's just the irony of ironies. I don't even think about it. And my way of describing, if somebody wants to say, oh, you're a tough guy, I go, listen, man, I understand you're a very tough guy. I have been beaten up by folks so much more tougher than you, it doesn't matter. So that explained the self-defense side. Second thing was the girl. My wife, she's like, don't talk about me. I'm like, I won't. My favorite wife and I have been married for 25 and a half years. She's my first wife, and she's my only wife, but she is still my favorite wife. And we are one of the greatest couples in the history of couples. Because we want to be. Because it's not about us. It's not about me. It's not about her. It's about us. And we work at it. We work really hard at it. And the little things are the big things. And how many people have ever had anybody in their life who all of a sudden, they sit you down and go, you know, I've had enough. I've been meaning to say this. And then they get this blow off top. And it's like a garbage truck. And they just dump it on you. We've all had that happen, right? The key is to not let that pressure build up. That's the key, is to address it, to not ignore it. The little things are the big things. The little things are the big things. And I always like telling the story, it's like, if you're going to a doorway, it never gets old if you approach a doorway and go, after you. And then someone else goes, no, after you. That never gets old. The minute somebody comes up to you, they cut you off. That sits in your head. And those things add up over time. They add up over time. It's like a rotten piece of sand. And there's no pearl that's going to come out of it. It's going to spoil the soup. I really encourage you, the little things are the big things. Trust me, you can veer off course very quickly with your head down and you're not paying attention. Now, the big story I have to talk about is the difference between being rich and being wealthy. Now, I wanted to be rich. I was convinced. I taught martial arts all this time, came outside, it was great. I met my wife. Well, she wasn't my wife, she was my girlfriend. But I was broke. I was just broke. Now it was important, it didn't really matter for me eating ramen every day, but I kind of wanted to have a family and buy nice things. One of my students had this Mercedes. This is back, it had windshield wipers on the headlights. I had known him for 3 years, his name is Brian. And I go, Brian, what do you do? He goes, I'm chairman of the board of the Coffee Sugar Cocoa Exchange. And I went, can you teach me how to do that? Just like I teach you Taekwondo? And he goes, sure. I go to work. I showed him, he was being at my house at 5 o'clock tomorrow morning. I showed up at 4 o'clock. I was afraid he was gonna leave without me. It's a true story. Spent 9.5 years on Wall Street. I won't bore the story. 9.5 years, got up 2:30 in the morning every single day, traded Europe, got on the bus, took a nap, got to my desk, 6:45, traded, came back, making money was great, really great. Losing money? Not so much fun. Not so much fun. I remember in high school, we had a speaker come, give a story and said, okay, take this notebook and we're gonna give you a job. We're gonna pay you $1 million a year to flip pages. Would you do it? Every single hand went up. $1 million, sit down, just flip pages. I hope I didn't mess up somebody's speech here. I went to Wall Street, spent 9.5 years banging my head against the wall, had met my wife. I've ridden the market up and down. I've made and lost millions. Made it, lost it, made it, lost it. And then in 2004, I had a life-altering moment. I was in the back office arguing over the trade settlement with Bob Lisy. And for the adults in the room, you know that scene in Superman with Christopher Reeve when Jonathan Kent stares at his arm and he sees the vein going, he goes, oh no, and he clutches his heart. I'm yelling at Bob Lisy over the settlement price of Alcatel and where the euro price was, and I'm watching the marbles in my vein put out. And I go, I can't believe I'm gonna die arguing with Bob Lisy! They take me to my doctor. My doctor saved my life. She goes, I got good news and I got bad news. She goes, the good news is you didn't have a heart attack. The bad news is you had a panic attack. Well, excuse me? She repeated, how is not having a heart attack bad news? And I couldn't process it. She goes, men like you don't change your lifestyle until you have a heart attack. And then it'll be too late. And I quit. Now, my happy place when I was a kid was always tinkering. I always liked fixing things. Legos, lawnmower, mini bike, motorcycle. My lawnmower story, I told, says Principal Raines, but my lawnmower story was my old man, I mentioned he was not a great guy. We had a lawnmower that didn't work. I took it apart. He came home. I got the beating of a lifetime. You start that, put that thing back together. Don't come in the house till you get in. Great. Put that thing together. First pull. Started right up. Talk about a happy place. Fixing things. It was a waif, and that began my journey of being in my garage in the middle of the night. Right, Miranda? Tinkering away. So I left Wall Street, and we had this big giant house, and I decided, I'll get another job on Wall Street, I'm gonna just renovate it. 6 months go by, I'm unemployed, friend of my family goes, hey, you know, I don't mean to insult you, but would you like to remodel our bathroom? Miranda was like, go. I said, all right, a friend of mine was unemployed, I hired him, go to work. 3 days into it, second life-altering moment. My wife goes, oh my God, I got my husband back. And I was hooked. I was absolutely hooked. And I was lost for another 10 years. Another 10 years I spent focusing on the product. Our company motto is quality projects for quality people. And I was obsessed with the projects. What's the project? What's the project? What's the project? Obsessed with it. By the way, our valedictorian, you are a smart cookie. Because I'm stealing your line. I had it written, but I'm going to give her all the credit. It's amazing. I knew she was going to say it. Sorry. Life happens. I had this plan, the girl, defend myself, get rich. 10 years on Wall Street, banging my head against what didn't work. 10 years of construction, banging my head against 2x4s. And we have a life-altering moment. Now, the doctor, I'm sorry, I forgot your last name, was sitting next to me. She goes, are you prepared for this? My head, I went, I've been spending my entire life preparing for this moment. Just as you graduates have spent your entire life preparing for this moment, just as all of you out there have spent your entire life preparing for this moment right now. And our family had a surprise. We had something jump off the TV set. We had a criminal in our lives that completely altered the course of our lives. Horrible stuff. The stuff that you see on TV, except the stuff you see on TV happens to real people. Lost our house, lost 90% of our friends. I was so messed up, I thought I had brain damage. I remember, because it was so stressful. I remember Uncle Bob Janis bringing him in, no, Bob, there's nothing wrong with me, my brain doesn't. Well, they diagnosed me with PTSD. Because of the crimes that were committed against our family. It was horrific. Absolutely horrific. I didn't plan for this. This wasn't supposed to happen. The plan was not get beat up, get the girl, and get rich. That's life. I want to share with you graduates the greatest piece of advice that I was ever given. And it was by my Uncle Joe. Uncle Joe, God rest his soul, the greatest human being on the planet. And he gave me a wonderful piece of advice, it is universal. He was a little kid. I was a little kid in the band, missed his concert. I was home sick as a dog, crying my eyes out because I couldn't see Maynard Ferguson, da da da. Uncle Joe comes by and comes upstairs. He goes, "You seem pretty upset." I'm like, "Did the snot bubbles give it away in the red eyes?" He goes, "Enjoy being sick. Enjoy being sick. Enjoy being sick." I go, "I don't get it." He goes, "Man made you chicken soup, didn't you?" I was like, "Yeah." "You got the black and white TV with 29 channels and the rabbit ears in your bedroom. That's pretty good. You get to stay up late and watch Johnny Carson. TV show, wait a minute. Do you have any homework?" Like, "No." Enjoy it. Greatest piece of advice, because when the hurricane hit, and here we are, broken. I mean, broke and broken. I heard my uncle in my head, "Enjoy being sick." And I did not want to be part of the problem. I had lost 27 pounds from stress. I mean, literally, lost my money, lost my house, and I was losing myself, disappearing. And I woke up one morning and said, "How am I going to get through this?" Sat on the side of the bed, socks first, then shoes. And I knew right then, just like that high block, just like one relationship at a time, that I could rebuild my life. Now, I'm going to give you another piece of advice. How many of you dream of being rich? Anybody here? All right, put your hands down. How about dreaming of being wealthy? Not as many hands. Work with me on this. So to me, where it all changed was when I was so broken, couldn't figure out what to do, I realized what really mattered is what room I'm in, who I surround myself with. If you provide value to someone, you're entitled to a piece of it. All of a sudden I realized, because we were so broken, it didn't matter what I was doing, it mattered who I was surrounding myself with. I fired half the subcontractors in my life, I didn't care because they were just jerks. I fired half the customers in my life. The pandemic hit. I wound up following all of our customers to their vacation homes. Here's another question for you. How many people have heard business is business, you shouldn't work for friends and family? You heard that one? It's wrong. Why would you not want to work for friends and family? I mean, if you were a singer and you were given this talent and you could sing, would you only sing to strangers and people that didn't like you? Or would you sing to the adoring fans that wanted to throw money at you? If you have a restaurant, are you going to serve people in your restaurant, people that like don't like your food, that don't want to come back? No, you're going to have fans, and it clicked. Most people didn't want to work for friends and family. That's all I wanted to do. And you know what? I get paid a pretty good amount of money now to follow all my friends and family across the country. I get paid to fly across the country and fix people's houses. Why not? Why not? I do a good job. I have a handshake that I can honor, and I'm really proud of it. If you provide value to somebody, you're entitled to a piece of it. And now our valedictorian, thank you for starting the thunder. There's an asterisk on it. You're entitled to be one of the people you provide value to. That was the thing that I was missing. I spent my entire life looking for the prize. Entire life. If I could just make a little more money, great. In a boardroom, if I could just get the past presidents to give me a vote, great. But finally realized, I'm one of the people that's allowed to provide. I like tinkering. I like people. I don't like bullies. I don't like bullies. I like people that stand up for the underdog. That I have figured out, finally getting the hang of life. If you provide value to others, you're entitled to a piece of it, but you, dear graduate, you matter. You have a happy place. God gave you a talent. I believe this in my bones, that each of you had a God-given talent. Some of you have like 15 God-given talents. You have a responsibility to take your talent and bring it to others. That's your job. Whatever your talent is, don't do it because mom and dad say you're supposed to. Don't do it because it's Memorial Day's coming. I understand. I am so grateful for all of you that serve, all this pressure. Don't look for the approval of your father's ghost. Look for your own approval. Find what makes you happy and then bring it out. Dear graduates, I wish somebody had shared this with me. It's just as simple as making a fist and defending yourself. If you provide value to someone, you're entitled to a piece of it. I hope the piece that you get is massive. I hope you are adored by your friends. I hope you have tons of money, but I hope more importantly that you're wealthy. Wealth, real wealth, to me being rich is one dimensional. That's just a prize, it's just a bank end. Being wealthy, I'm one of the wealthiest people I know because I get to be surrounded by you. Congratulations, graduate. Thank you very much for the honor of doing this. And I wish you Godspeed, and may one of you come back 37 years later and give your keynote. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Coppola. Guys, did you hear him? Did you hear his message? Did you get his message? Okay. So the difference between wealthy and rich, I wanted you to get that. All the other messages I want you to get. But one of the things that I really, really, really want you to know, and it's probably the first time I've ever told a senior class this, if this isn't it, if the college that you pick, if the major that you declare is not it, and you figure that out, it's okay to change. It's okay to reinvent yourself. Don't commit and get stuck. Don't commit and get stuck. There are so many people out there in jobs or careers, and they're miserable. They can take care of their families, but they're miserable. Find something you love, even if it takes reinventing yourself 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Even if you're 35, 40 years old before you do it, find something you love and do it. All right? Again, another round of applause for Mr. Coppola. We appreciate you being here with us today. And now the moment that we've all been waiting for. Before I continue, I want to ask all of my parents and audience members to stay seated. I know you want to take pictures. I have a professional photographer sitting right here. All right, she's going to get pictures of your kids getting their diplomas. Then they're going to have their pictures taken again over there. You guys will have access to all of these in a few weeks, so please remain seated. Don't block anybody else's views. Okay, guys, I know how important photos are, but we're getting it done for you, I promise. Announcing this year's recipients is going to be Miss Butler. She's worked closely with this year's graduating seniors over the years. She's had most of them in at least one, sometimes two or three classes over the years. She is She feels especially close to them, and she's honored to call their names and share their accomplishments with you. Their accomplishments will be up on the screen. Before I do that, though, before I ask her to come up here, I want to take a few minutes to recognize a few other people. I have no idea if they're even here today, but if Ms. Stratton is here, I'd like to recognize her. She will be leaving us at the end of the year and moving up north. Mr. Hopper is going to be retiring. Ms. Bowling is moving back to Okeechobee County. And unfortunately, Mr. and Mrs. Butler are going to Alabama, so we're losing a lot this year. So they will all be missed. They will all be missed, but as you heard from some of our student speeches a few minutes ago, Ms. Butler has done a lot. She has been the English department head since 2017. She has sponsored the Student Government Association, organized dances, events, homecomings, field day, house games, teacher appreciation activities. She's mentored new teachers, handled dismissal for years, dealt with almost being run over by you guys on a regular basis, getting poured on and diving out of the way of lightning strikes on a regular basis to make sure that your kids get in your cars in the afternoon safely. And I'm sure she's done a million other things that she sends out reminders for department meetings and faculty meetings and handles those agendas. I'm sure she's done a lot more than I'm leaving off. But my point is that her absence is going to be felt throughout our school community. And while we are extremely saddened to see her go, we do understand and respect that she has to do what's in the best interest of her family. So with that being said, I do want to present her with a few tokens of our appreciation. When you write your new lesson plans, where you're going, use this and remember your Spartan family to write your new lesson plans with, and to also write that letter back to me that says, hey, I missed it, I'm coming back. All right, I'll be checking the mail for that. To Ashley Butler, ELA Department Head, Student Government Sponsor, 2018 through 2023, in recognition of your blood, sweat, and tears over the years, you are appreciated, and you will be missed. With love, your Spartan family. Once a Spartan, always a Spartan. And it's really important for me to tell her that she's appreciated because I suck at that. So my teachers and my staff will tell you the one thing that is my major weakness is that I suck at telling them when they do a good job. I just assume they know. And I'm terrible at that. And she has been the angel or devil on my shoulder. On a regular range, you got to remember to tell them they're appreciated. You got to remember to tell them when they're doing a good job. Ms. Butler, you have done a fabulous job, and I really, really wish you weren't going. And we all appreciate you. So with that, she's going to present our seniors.
You have to go this way. Okay. See, I was all good and I had stopped crying and everything until that. Thank you, Rains. Gotta find my paper. Okay. All right. Ready? Juliet Star Puig will be attending the University of Florida and majoring in biomolecular chemistry. Milan Patel, attending Florida State University, majoring in information systems.
Gianni Joseph Gauthier, attending Indian River State College, majoring in sports medicine. Isabel Crystal Stevens, attending Florida Atlantic University, majoring in science.
You can do it.
I don't know if I can do this one. Brianna Tucker, attending Florida Gulf Coast University, majoring in secondary education. Okay, I tried really hard to get through this without any more tears. Okay. Patricia Ann Marie Orlean, attending the University of Miami, majoring in biology. Jamani Brielle Parker, attending Florida International University, majoring in biomedical engineering. Brianna Lee Horner, attending Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, majoring in aerospace engineering. Isabella Marini, attending University of Florida, majoring in pre-med. Ariba Narudin, attending the University of Florida, majoring in psychology. Olivia Mati Rios, attending the University of South Florida, majoring in biology. Ivana Mihailovic, attending the University of Florida, majoring in veterinary sciences. Josue Giovanni Cruz, attending Florida Atlantic University, majoring in biology. Harley Isabel Fleschner, attending Marymount Manhattan College, majoring in journalism. Carly Alicia Abraham, attending the University of Central Florida and majoring in political science. Cassidy Astrid Beal, attending Indian River State College, majoring in business administration. Mariana Valle Nunez, attending the University of Central Florida, majoring in biology. Kaylee Constance Wilkes, attending the University of Central Florida, majoring in business and marketing. Madison Shore, attending Florida Institute of Technology, majoring in mechanical engineering. Cristobal Augustin Oyarzun, attending University of Central Florida, majoring in kinesiology. Brinley Lynn Johnson, attending Florida Atlantic University, majoring in business. Joseph Leon Rosario, attending Indian River State College, majoring in computer design. Dionysia Ava Polizois, attending Florida Atlantic University Honors College, majoring in accounting. This is a special one for us. Janelius Rivera Pomales, Indian River State College, majoring in health management. Colton James Psychotti, attending Florida Polytechnic University, majoring in cybersecurity engineering. Dylan Taryn Harry Prasad, attending the University of South Florida, majoring in health science.
Bless you.
Gabriel Stephen Agripides, attending IRSC, majoring in engineering. Nicholas John Answish, attending Indian River State College, majoring in business. Isabella Grace Aponte, attending Indian River State College, majoring in psychology. Simran Bizram, attending Indian River State College, majoring in biology. Darren Lance Bonholm, attending Indian River State College, majoring in finance. No, you take that this time. Connor Bostick, attending IRSC, majoring in business. Grace Hurtado Bradshaw, attending Indian River State College, majoring in psychology. Danae Alicia Butler, attending Florida Institute of Technology, majoring in marketing. Dominique Marie Canyon, attending Indian River State College to study veterinary science. Colin Michael Cash, attending Indian River State College, studying biology. Kendall Marie Cash, attending Indian River State College to study English. Alejandro Castellanos. Nico Thomas Sherlanzio, attending Indian River State College, majoring in automotive. Mia Katia Corrado, attending Indian River State College, studying graphic design. Kimani Alexander Creary, attending Indian River State College to study mental health. Lindsay Grace DeLeon, attending Indian River State College to study fire science. Alvin Norbert La Chica Diaz, Jr., attending Indian River State College in the RN program. Jordan Mason Dinwiddie, also attending Indian River State College to study in the RN program. Delaney Jane Dixon, attending Indian River State College to study business. Noelia Dominguez Negron, attending Ringling College of Art and Design and studying illustration. Casey James Dunlap, attending Southeastern University with a major in Biblical Studies. William Travis Dunn III, attending Fisk University, studying computer science. Nathan Santos Fernandez, attending Indian River State College and studying accounting. Bianca Forsythe, attending Indian River State College, studying early childhood education. Darian DePaul Freeman will be entering the United States Military Air Force branch. Mendez entering the United States Military Air Force Division. Timothy Gerald attending Indian River State College and studying automotive. Daniel Anthony Goodgame attending Fortis Institute studying HVAC. Miguel Angel Granada Varela attending Indian River State College and studying in the RN program. Crystal Keisha Guerriere attending Ringling College of Art and Design and studying illustration. Lily Madison Hadler attending Indian River State College, majoring in secondary education. Elisa Jade Hare attending Indian River State College, studying psychology. Blaze Montgomery Harrison entering the United States military to be an Army drone pilot. Connor James Henderson attending Indian River State College and majoring in software engineering. Blake Thomas Horner. Sarah Marie Hoxie attending Indian River State College and majoring in social work. Come on, Darion. Do it, baby. Kaylee Elizabeth Hurley attending Indian River State College studying forensic science. Olivia Ivana Ivoron attending Indian River State College with a major in criminal justice. Ariella Shania Jacobs attending the University of Connecticut studying psychological sciences. Dante Terrell Jenkins attending Indian River State College studying psychology. Michael James Jennings attending Indian River State College studying computer science. Jarrell Antonio Jimenez entering the United States Military Air Force branch. Amaya Minglesia Joseph attending Indian River State College studying in the RN program. Austin James Keenan attending Indian River State College with a major in criminal justice. Caden Riley Kelliger attending Indian River State College with a major in business administration. Hannah Riley Kinney attending Indian River State College with a major in English. Joshua Sarkis Kacharian attending Indian River State College to study the dramatic arts. Denise Abigail King attending Indian River State College studying architectural design. Nicholas Alexander Lazarus attending Indian River State College majoring in biology. Chloe Laurel Lewis attending Indian River State College with a business administration major. Trinity Alexis Lewis, attending Indiana River State College, studying foreign languages. Dylan Douglas Long, attending the University of Miami, majoring in pre-med. Alexis Marie Marrero, attending Indian River State College, studying business. Carla Medina Montes de Oca, attending Indian River State College, studying cybersecurity. Gabriel Michael Mendez, attending Indian River State College with a major in engineering. Troy Thomas Moss, attending Indian River State College with a major in business. Tyler Jared Narcisse, attending Valencia Community College with a major in business. Caroline Olivia Nass. Isabella Padilla, attending Indian River State College, studying music. Seth Paley, entering the United States Military Marines. Amanda Vivine Pierce, attending Indian River State College and studying in the RN program. Coe Brianne Pearson, attending Florida Atlantic University, studying linguistics. Adriana Zoraida Perez. Tristan, you're welcome. Tristan Antonio Perosi. Evan Michael Puentes, attending Indian River State College, studying music. You have a lot of fans. Lexi Marie Pyle Torres, attending Indian River State College, studying radiology. Austin Jason Ricucci, attending Indian River State College, studying carpentry. Alexa Liliana Sines, attending Indian River State College, studying electrical engineering. Emiliano Salas, attending Northwest Lineman College, studying power lineman. Adriana Singh, attending Indian River State College to study the RN program. Brian Cecil Singh, attending Indian River State College, studying in criminal justice. Ryan Lucas Skinner, attending the University of Central Florida to major in creative writing. Yeah. Brianna Jade Smith, attending Indian River State College, studying cosmetology. Jade Danielle Smith, entering the United States Military Army. Vivian Alexandra Solis, attending Indian River State College, studying computer science. Makai Maurice Spratley, Ozzy Sternberg, attending Wrigley College of Art and Design, majoring in illustration.
I'm going to cry if you keep talking.
Oh, you got it?
It's okay, it's okay.
Christian Alexander Swanson, attending Indian River State College, majoring in accounting. Imani Sylvester, attending Indian River State College, studying in the RN program. Jason Arturo Tabras, attending Indian River State College, studying in psychology. Tiva Leah Lalosa Taylor, attending Indian River State College, studying business administration. Joshua Michael Titus, attending Indian River State College, studying cybersecurity. Marie Troutman, attending Indian River State College, studying in the RN program. Alexander Velasco, attending Nova Southeastern University, studying sports administration. Owen Watson, entering the United States Military Air Force Division. Mackenzie Lynn Whistler, attending Indian River State College, studying in business. Maximino Josiah Whitehead. Jaden Abigail White, attending Indian River State College with a major in psychology. Parker Robert Williams II, attending FAU ROTC program with a focus in the Army. Dina Casafaris, attending Port St. Lucie Beauty Academy, studying cosmetology. Congratulations, class of 2023. You did it.
We're all just gonna sit here awkwardly until they're all back up on stage. You can cheer, fill the silence. Please join me in a special round of applause for the graduates of Somerset College Prep Academy Charter High School. And now to officially welcome the new graduates, Dr. Ruth Jacoby, Somerset Academy's Executive Director of Education.
Before I make it official, I do want to congratulate each and every guest that's here today, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart for choosing Somerset for your education of your children. They are absolutely remarkable. I couldn't be more proud. Graduates, before I give you the last command from a Somerset person, I did want to say to you, may all your wishes come true and that life will be beautiful. Can you please rise? Class of 2023, as a symbol of your graduation from Somerset College Preparatory Academy, senior class, you may now turn your tassels from the right side to the left.
Distinguished guests, family members, and friends for being with us here today to welcome our eighth group of Somerset College Prep alumni. They are alumni now. I want to say thank you to the Mid-Florida Event Center for hosting our graduation and for hosting our senior banquet the other night. I definitely have to shout out to our IT team over here for all their hard work towards graduation. Yeah.
They will have the entire recording of today's events ready to go and on the school's YouTube page sometime before tomorrow morning. I want to thank Ms. Russo for the countless hours that she put into ensuring that all the names were spelled correctly on the slideshow. I want to thank Jasmine Henry for the slideshow that she puts together that you guys come into and will be going out to, pictures of your children from the time they entered Somerset in 6th, 7th, 8th, or 9th grade until now. Thank you, Jasmine, for putting that together. I want to thank Cutting Edge, Crumble Cookies, KLS Designs, Our SGA, Flowers by Susan for everything that they put into today's events for us. And my most heartfelt thank you, where is she? She already in the back. My most heartfelt thank you to the woman without whom this would not happen. The senior banquet would not happen. Miss Jennifer Silva, thank you so much. Now I'm going to ask all of the audience members to remain seated during the recessional. Once the recessional is complete, the graduates will come back out to meet you for pictures. And then after they're done with their pictures, they need to bring their gowns back to the holding rooms to exchange them for their actual diplomas, because all those were empty. All right. To my guest speaker, Mr. Coppola, there is a gift underneath your chair. Please don't leave without it. To my seniors, there are gift bags under your chairs. It is now time to take those. And one last congratulations, class of 2023.